The Ministry of Environment is countering the devastating effects of indiscriminate charcoal burning in northern Uganda by involving farmers to plant up to 45 million trees in 2023.
Because of pressure, because of maybe greed, that I might submit, people have gone over and beyond. And they are over-harvesting. Not only harvesting, but not even cutting trees, they're actually literally uprooting trees. So these trees will never grow again.
To this effect, the Permanent Secretary at the Ministry of Water and Environment, Okot Alfred Okidi, has signed a memorandum of understanding with Kijani Forestry in Gulu to supply and trade farmers who will plant fast-growing trees such as Malaina.
OU is actually going to help us address this problem by engaging the private sector directly and also taking away the middlemen who are the ones who are actually profiteering from the charcoal trade.
In Paibona village in Gulu district, the farmers have taken up the initiative. Ochira Godfrey, a 37-year-old father of two, is optimistic that tree planting will improve the livelihoods of the people in his village.
Because if I plant my own tree, I just know that I have to control, because it's now it's like my sweat. I make it with my own sweat, so it's not like a natural forest, but I'm just doing with my horn to be with my natural forest and whatever. That's why I decided to plant my own tree with my family. When we plant a lot of tree, even our children in our generation, they will just continue, even if I'm around or I'm not around.
Gulu district has become a haven for illegal charcoal business, which has led to the widespread tree cutting across Acholi sub-region.
We know that in a family, there will be firewood, because it's typically women who go for firewood. So what we are trying to do is to plant these trees that can help us to make charcoal, so we don't have them looking for firewood very far off.
Kijani Forestry will buy the trees from the farmers for charcoal and timber production. This comes at a time when political leaders across Acholi sub-region are blaming each other for the escalating illegal charcoal business.
Some of the threats also come in a way that you hear some technical staff telling you that arms, eyes on, arms off. Whereas for them, they go with all these two objectives. Both eye and arms, they're all there. I, being the indigenous of Gulu, I want to attest to you that Gulu deserve to be what? Put on ban. Because we used to have Bungatira forest. Now go and see, it is not there. We used to have forest in Patiko. Go and see, it is not there. We can struggle, even if I only see one tree, I have to struggle for that tree not to be cut off.
Fairly with rural farmers kind of all over northern Uganda. So we're in 16 districts now. About 30,000 households are working with us. And you know, when we combine that, our infrastructure, with the knowledge and the expertise that the ministry provides and their understanding of the context, I think that we can really, really change the tree cover in northern Uganda and kind of throughout the whole country.
The Ministry of Water and Environment will work hand in hand with Kijani Forestry for the next 5 years.
It is going to go up to 2028, but it is renewable. It is renewable. So government is going to work with Kijani in identification of the species. Will also work train.
The target is to raise the forest cover across the country to at least 18%. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu.